So my name is Cheng Luo. I'm the bada evangelist from Samsung UK. So today I'm going to guide you or talk a little bit about how the location-based service application works on bada. So the services on bada, currently we have four types of service available from bada. The first one is social service, and location service, content service, and the commerce service. So there are more services actually available from the bada 2.0 SDK, for example, like the advertisement service and push notification, live logging. So there are more services coming from the server side. And Samsung actually providing this service, the server infrastructure, for free for you guys to use. There's a question asking about how the service can be used or charged. Actually, I just want to make clear, Samsung providing type of infrastructure, these type of things managed by Samsung, are totally free to use. And the question is related, like if you have a massive content and streaming and access to the server, we actually don't physically storing your media files or content itself. So we catching the metadata on our server, and your content actually will be stored on the Amazon S3 workspace. So this part of fee charge you pay to Amazon, and we keep the metadata, we provide you the searching and sharing mechanism of our server. So this is a two separate server. I will give you a little bit detail in the later slide. So the picture shows you how this the infrastructure, the server being deployed. So as you can see here, on the top side, you have the bada server. And the bada server is acting as a mediator. They're talking to the third-party server. So we have signed a lot of legal contract with the third-party provider, make sure we have the right to accessing their server and to read their credential and user information. So we, for example, I listed here, we can access the Jakarta server to get the map information, point of interest, and landmarks. We also can access the third-party social network server service, for example, Facebook. You can authenticate your Facebook, your application with Facebook via Samsung server, so you don't need to using the FML or the web the HTTP call to do this kind of authentication. It all can be done via the native C++ API. And we also can access the Twitter and MySpace. And for the content side, as I already mentioned, so we Samsung server is talking to the Amazon S3 server, so we are retrieving those content meta information from the Amazon server. So this is basically the big picture, how Samsung server works with the other service. And then the service is also a nice way to integrate the third-party solutions, for example, as a Facebook, Twitter, or MySpace. If you're using the map, and we're currently using the Jakarta map as a default service provider. So these are all integrated into Samsung server and provide a native C++ API for you to access them. And the question is like, can you use the service on your on Samsung Android phone? Currently, it's not. But I don't want to say technically it's all possible, because the server side is RESTful API. It's just because currently we haven't opened those service to any other platform. Currently, it's just for bada. So it goes a little bit detail. So the first one is the social service. So what kind of apps you can write, or what kind of service you can get from the social service namespace. So the words I highlight in the blue are the namespaces you can find from the server namespace. For example, the buddy service, it's actually managing your buddy relations. You can request the new friends, delete the new friends, and the sharing information among the friends. And profile service also can searching and updating different type of profiles. For example, you can put your phone numbers, social profiles like your Twitter account, your Facebook account, and you can sharing the information among those accounts. And the SNS gateway is the very key namespace that can provide you easy integration for the other third-party solutions, for example, the Facebook. The last one is the messaging service, providing the free messaging service by the bada server. So you can, besides the SMS, you also can use in the bada server to send a free message, like the instant type of messaging service. And then the second service we provide is the location service. What location service does is also simplify in the four category. The first one is the map service. Basically, it can display a map inside your application. You can point to zoom the maps easily. And my live coding will be using the map service. And geocoding service is translate the coordinates to the readable address or vice versa. So you've got reverse geocoding service from the location namespace too. And the third one is the route service. So route service is finding the route between two coordinates. This route information actually you get from the Decada server. So they calculate the route and they send you the result. So it's not from Samsung server. And then the last one is the directory service. It's providing the point of interest information. And for example, the current very popular location-based application like Foursquare, this type of check-in service is actually utilize this directory service. So you gave a keywords like a restaurant, Starbucks, a bar, a cafe, and you're retrieving a list of landmarks from the Decada server and tells you what's the nearest point of interest around you. And you can do some like type, oh, I'm here at Starbucks in Chiswick. So this is the part of service you can do for your own check-in type application. And I also will covering this directory service in my live coding. The third service is the content service. As you all know, currently the hot application like the photo sharing and blogging, live blogging, and they all use music apps, they all utilize a lot of content from the server side, from the cloud-based. So that's why we choose the Amazon S3 server. So it's really, the content is on the cloud, and your application can be really accessible by globally the user base. And from the content service namespace, you got the remote content or local content info. So that's the metadata physically storage on your device or the bada server. Remember, it's just the metadata. For example, like the file names, file size, and where the files, the URL of the file on the Amazon S3 server. So it's not the file itself. And also you got the content manager or remote content manager, which can create, update, and delete this content on the device or on the server. And you also get this searching function from this content searching or remote content searching. So you can find the content from the device or from the server. And the last one is the remote content sharing. So basically, if you utilize the social namespace, you have a relationship with some other bada user, and all those content from the different user can be shared. So that's also available from the content namespace. And the last one is the commerce service, which is quite interesting. I personally think it's a potential, maybe the popular service you can use for your application. Basically, it's the in-app purchasing features you can utilize. For example, the item info is the items you want to sell on your application. So it's not the application itself. It's something else, like you have a game. People downloading the game free from the Samsung App Store, but you can sell the game items from your game. And you can utilize the game info to give the price, a picture, or description of the specific items. And the item service can allow you to create and get the item from the Samsung App Store. So before you're doing the commerce service, you have to configure your items on the Samsung App Store, so on the server side, on the cloud. And the device will retrieve those information, use the commerce service. And then finally, you can purchase those items. The purchase information will provide you the information about the price of the items, the names, and currency, what kind of currency is being purchased. And the last one is the purchase service, which allows you to get the item from the store. So you can list what items are available from your in-app purchasing, and you can retrieve those information from the server. So basically, this is a four type of service available from the bada 1.2.1 SDK. And there will be more a new service available from a 2.0.